Hey, sa mga viewers ng Kurt TV, more power po sa inyo.
You have gotten a lot of attention ever since becoming mayor, and especially now when it comes to like your management of the COVID-19 situation. Why do you think you're getting such a positive response when it comes to the policies that you're doing there in Pasig?
I only have two qualifications for people who want to work with me. Number one, integrity. And number two, competence. People who have integrity, people who have competence. And it's a mixture. You know, we have people who are older than me, with more experience than me, especially when it comes to local governance. But I also brought in people who have little to no experience in local government. As long as they had those two qualities, everything else can be learned. Skills can be learned. The bureaucratic processes can be learned. But integrity and competence, those are very hard to teach. Let them do their jobs. Let them grow where they are without subjecting them to politics. Na kailangan sumama ka sa akin pag kampanya. Kailangan yung buong pamilya mo sa akin. Walang ganun dapat. And I think that's one of the things that really paved the way for a smooth transition. And you know, if I can just add, we were able to really find a lot of gems, you know, without mentioning names. Kasi magkasilisan na, no? Without mentioning names, we were able to find people na 10 years na nasa isang position, na isang office, hindi masyadong nagagamit yung talents. And then nahugot namin, nalagay namin sa isang position kung saan mas makakapag-excel siya. We have a lot of countless stories like that.
And how are you doing right now, like you personally, with everything that's happening? Do you still have time to relax?
To relax? Not that much. But especially now, we're in the middle of a crisis. And I really take some time to rest. I think minsan parang meron tayong, I don't know kung nasa culture ba yun or ano na, parang grabe, ito, ang tao ito, hindi natutulog. 3 oras lang sa isang gabi natutulog to. And sometimes we praise that. Pero ang totoo, dapat nagpapahinga din tayo eh. If we want our brains and our bodies to work at full potential, kailangan nagpapahinga tayo kahit ilang oras man lang sa gabi.
So a lot of our readers really wanted to know why you wanted to run and like your experience as a young mayor. So like, just to start off, like, what's it like being a mayor now amid the pandemic?
It's very strange. Sometimes it really feels a bit surreal. Parang minsan mapapaisip ka, panaginip ba ito? It's very weird, you know. And the thing, the difficult thing about this is that it's never happened before, at least not in our lifetimes, and not with this situation, not under these circumstances, and with the technology that we have now, etc. So there have been pandemics before, pero hindi gantong klase. So, hindi ganto yung scenario or circumstances. So, it's not like we can open a textbook and say na, ito yung pwede natin gawin. Or, it's not like I can ask someone who became a mayor under these circumstances before. But, yeah, it's pretty strange. And the sad part is, well, obviously this whole thing, wala naman masaya dito, no? But one of the sad things is that a lot of our programs that we planned when you know, my administration started, maraming na-discarril. A lot of them were delayed. Some we really just had to cancel or postpone indefinitely, especially our program for universal healthcare with the millions of pesos that we have to spend to fight this pandemic or COVID-19. Talagang na-delay yung universal healthcare program namin. That's just one. That's the main thing, but that's just one of many programs or projects that we've had to postpone indefinitely. And even after, you know, let's say, kunwari, matapos na yung quarantine period o wala na talagang COVID-19. Marami sa pondo na gastos na namin to fight COVID-19. You know, we had to establish a referral center. We converted one of our hospitals to become a COVID referral center. Yun, ang laki ng gastos namin. Yung pagpapa-negative pressure pa lang ng ibang areas nun, may git 50 million na kagad yun. So these are the things that we don't really know. Kumbaga, dahil nasira yung mga plano natin.
Can you talk about sort of like coming into this, what was your intended like leadership style when you became mayor?
I think one of the main pillars of our leadership here is that we want to be inclusive, participatory. Ibig sabihin, bago mag-desisyon, dapat kinukonsulta muna lahat. We have the saying, konsultasyon bago aksyon. And that's something that we've really been working hard to establish here in Pasig. I don't want to talk about politics right now. I don't think it's the right time. But siguro kung saan kami nanggaling dito sa Pasig, we wanted to really transform the style of governance to really really becoming inclusive na hindi takot yung tao sa gobyerno. There's a partnership. Hindi lang parang okay kayong beneficiary, kami nagbibigay ng tulong. Kundi palitan yung mindset na yon na partner ang gobyerno saka ang mamamayan. And we've spent a lot of time working with civil society. We've spent a lot of time yung binubuhay namin yung mga proseso at mekanismo ng pakikilahok sa pamahalaan, yung participatory governance. A lot of the things that were in the local or are in the local government code and in our ordinances but weren't implemented in the past. That's one of the thrusts. So again, in one word to answer your question, inclusive style of governance and leadership.
And what's it like being so young as a mayor? Like when you became mayor, you were like 29 years old, now you're 30. Do you feel like this is working to your favor?
I don't see it as a disadvantage. Obviously, there are some people, if you've been there for 20 years or 30 years in the same position or in the same environment, it's very hard to change behavior. It's very hard to change patterns. It's very hard to change things that are institutionalized, even patterns of corruption. They're very hard to change. So the advantage for me coming in as a first-term mayor, I think regardless of my age, you know, I've had some other local government experience in the past before I became mayor. But as a first-term mayor, the advantage is wala pa akong masyadong baggage sa ganun. So yung perspektibo ko, it's more fresh. And again, getting people with me with the same line of thought, the same principles, the same values, we can really institute a lot of changes here in our city.
What is it about being mayor that you like? And then what is it about it that you don't like?
What I like about it is obviously my sphere of influence is bigger in the city. So I can, you know, the changes that I want to see in my city, I have a better shot at doing it rather than if I was not a mayor. So yun yung obviously maganda doon. There are a lot of programs that we have been doing. The mayorship is a action-packed job. Ang mayor, the actual, on the ground, puro action programs, projects na direct sa tao. That's the good part of it or the part that I appreciate. Yung con siguro, well, other than it's physically and mentally taxing, wala akong privacy. Sometimes it's hard to explain certain things. There are certain expectations. Yung ibang expectation tama, yung ibang mali. It's hard to communicate to 800,000 people. A simple policy like that, you think it's fairly easy to understand. But if you multiply it by 800,000 people, a simple policy direction like that, iba-iba na yung interpretation ng mga tao per office, per barangay, nag-iiba. So it's very hard. You know, social media helps, technology helps, but we're probably in step one or two only, or step one or two pa lang kami sa pag-utilize ng mga teknolohiya na to properly. Very early stages. Not everyone has access to it as well. So yun yung pinakamahirap para sa akin. That was really the biggest challenge for me when I first became mayor. July, August, until maybe around September, late September. The biggest challenge for me was where do I find the balance na kailangan mala makommunicate ko sa tao yung ginagawa ng pamahalaan at gustong gawin ng pamahalaan. Pero ayoko naman pumunta sa other extreme na epal na ako. Kaya kailangan lahat ng project ng city may malaking pangalan at mukha ko. So where do I draw the balance? That was the hardest thing for me. And as I mentioned earlier, I'm quite introverted. I don't talk to strangers, which is, I know it's weird for a mayor, pero yun yung pinakamahirap para sa akin. Right now, I feel like, you know, we found the balance. You know, the team and I have found the balance for that. But again, it's a work in progress and we're always trying to figure it out.
How do you deal with yung mga tao na, like people would define as plastic? Have you learned how to deal with them?
Yes. Siguro kahit anong profession naman, kahit anong industry, kahit anong trabaho, yung mga ganung klaseng tao naman. But it's the matter of, I can't control other people, but I can control what I think, I can control what I do. So I just have to focus on that.
What message would you give to aspiring public servants?
Just be prepared. Get prepared. Continuously prepare, both theoretically and on the ground in practice. It has to be both. Hindi pwedeng isa lang. Yung theoretical, reading books, studying leaders before you. Yung on the ground, hindi pwedeng lutang yung teorya mo. Hindi pwedeng lutang yung mga naiisip mo. Kailangan, ano yung actual realities on the ground? Kailangan practical, pragmatic tayo mag-isip. You know, I always say this when I go to schools and when I'm asked to speak at schools. But the saddest thing that I've seen in government, I'm not the most experienced, but I've had local government experience for maybe 7 or so years. And the saddest thing that I've seen in government is not the corruption. Although, of course, corruption is bad. It's saddening to see. Pero hindi yun yung pinakamalungkot na nakita ko. Yung pinakamalungkot na nakita ko, yung mga taong maganda yung puso, mabuti yung hangarin pumasok sa gobyerno. But because they're not well prepared, they're not prepared enough, nakakain sila ng sistema. To me, that's the number one saddest thing that we can see in government. Pagkakilala ko sa kanila, may integrity. Alam ko hindi sila magnanakaw. Mababait sila, mabuting ama o mabuting ina, mabuting asawa, mabuting anak. Pero pag nandun na sa sistema, pagpasok mo sa sistema, you need people in your life to tell you things like that. So be prepared, surround yourselves with good people who have the same principles, the same values as you do.
For you personally, how are you able to do this? Like, how are you able to avoid the systematic corruption in the country and keep yourself grounded?
Well, I never say I'm perfect, but I think what's working for me and the reason why I can stay away from corrupt practices, other than the fact that siguro how I was raised, my parents would have a lot to do with that, the values that they instilled in me. But I think that with the values that I grew up with, kung hindi ako handa, tapos pumasok lang ako bigla, kunyari fresh grad ako, pumasok ako bigla sa gobyerno, tumakbo ako agad, I probably would have ended up just like any other politician. And this really helped me and really formed not only my perspective, but yung concrete actions na gagawin ko was really determined by this. So I had good training. Kumbaga, hindi lang ako tumakbo kaagad. I was trained well and I was very blessed. I encountered the right people in my life so that hindi ako napunta sa maling landas. There are certain institutionalized practices na maling-mali talaga. Pero sa tagal na nangyayari na yun, no one says anything about it anymore. And yung iba nga, feeling nila tama na yun. It's already the correct way of doing things. So I think that's the right way to look at it. And so if we want to change that, it's not a matter of saying, itong tao na to, ang sama. I've learned not to judge people in that way na grabe, magnanakaw yan. Although, of course, kung magnanakaw yan, dapat maparusahan yan. Pero if you're trying to change the system, it's not enough just to shame these people. It's really changing the institutions itself.
A lot of people ask, like, how does President Vico Soto sound to you? Like, do you have any plans of running for president right now?
Right now, I'm here. I have to focus on the job that I was elected to do. And frankly, I think people at this point should just stop it with all of that because now is not the right time for that. And first of all, I'm only 30 years old. I'd appreciate if people would stop that. I know some of them are well-meaning. Yung iba baka nagbibiru lang or yung iba baka, I don't know, whatever the reasons are. But at this point, we should just stop that and focus on the task at hand.